Hey, we're not ready to start just yet, so hold on just a minute. I know you really want a plot frame, but hold on. We need some empty seats in the house. So if you have an empty seat around you or you're able to slide in, we have some folks in the back that this is what in Bible times I think they called gleaning, that there were a few pieces of grain they came and picked up. We're looking for a few empty seats. And if you're a fire marshal, you're probably wanted outside somewhere. All right. We got a few hands raised down here. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. All right. Seeing that. Hey, there's a couple down front here. Anybody else? All right, folks aren't moving forward. All right, I see those hands. Thank you. All right, hey, we're going to get started here. And I just want to say welcome to what I'm going to refer to as the greatest day at Briarwood over the course of the year. The Fine Arts Festival is unbelievable. I know you're fired up for it. And so let's give it up for the kids backstage here. They'll be coming out in just a minute. Hey, some of you came early and you had a chance to listen to the jazz band. Unbelievable. The band concert that we had last week was incredible. If you haven't had a chance to look at the art exhibit, it's incredible. It's absolutely incredible. And I do want to highlight a few folks because I want you to know what our arts folks are, what they're producing. Grace Galvin received a full tuition scholarship at Savannah College of Art and Design, won a larger scholarship SCAD. That's unbelievable. Mia Gables, if you go out there and look at some of the animation work Mia Gables did, it's just unbelievable. She was accepted into Lipscomb University's animated program. Only 20 students every year are admitted to that program, and she was one of them. Well done, Mia. Haddon Patterson received Birmingham Southern College Art and Design Scholarship. Congrats, Holden Patterson. And then, as you all know, we have the World Games coming here, and hopefully you've seen the incredible mural that our art department created out at the Oak Mountain State Park. It's absolutely beautiful, and one of our students was an incredible leader, Lindsay Liddell. She received a business scholarship rewarded for administrative and creative work, the World Games mural, and she's been selected into the Ringing School of Art and Design Virtual Gallery. She was only of 30 out of 400 that were chosen. So, Lindsay, well done. Awesome. You know, another reason I really love this night is because college students are starting to come home. And so, whether you are a college student who is home for the summer, or you came back just for this, or you are, I met an alumni who was in the fourth graduating class of Briarwood. This graduating class is going to be our 50th, but we have a member that was in the fourth graduating class. If you graduated from Briarwood and you're in the house, would you stand up so we can recognize you? Come on, jump to your feet like you're proud of it. Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate everyone who stood. Now we know where to have our advancement people. See you afterwards. All right. This is a wonderful evening. I hope you enjoy. Relax. It's a busy time of the year, but if you can just, this is really a worshipful experience. I was just backstage with a group that's going to be coming out here, and I can't tell you what a sweet time it was as they're cheering for each other and praying for each other, and seniors are starting to cry already. I'm like, hold on, we got to do a show. Don't start crying just yet. So it's going to be a sweet evening. Enjoy your time, particularly if you are a senior parent. If you're a senior parent, would you stand up? Oh, hi. You know, we should have had senior parents line up first to come in. We should do that next year. If you're a junior parent, mention that to the principal, and that should happen. That'd be a good suggestion. All right. If you would, let's open the evening in prayer, and then I'm going to get off the stage because I'm not the reason you came. So let's pray. Lord and Heavenly Father, we quiet our hearts to lift our thoughts, our meditations to you. Father's incredible talent has been exhibited tonight with instrument, with all the work that's been done with the art classes, and with what we're about ready to witness. We stand in absolute awe, Father. What a great God you are that these students have shown the discipline, the resolve, the willing to be led by their instructors. Father, I pray that tonight when they walk out here, they won't see 750 people, but they would see only you, that this would be a performance that you would smile upon, that this would be for an audience of one. Father, we desire that you would be glorified and lifted up. We thank you for Briarwood Christian School that has been a beacon of light in this community for 50 years. Lord, should you tarry, there may be another 50 plus. And Lord, we ask that all that's said here, all that's sung, the dancing, that yes, students did a phenomenal job, but may we have an outward and upward expression of deep gratitude in our hearts for who you are, for what you've done, for the opportunities these students have had, and how they have just stewarded them so well. Father, we pray that all that's done here would be an act of holy worship to you. In your name we pray, amen.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
I feel good, like I should.
You guys remember us?
Yeah.
We're sorry you have to see more of us.
We know you're excited.
Hi guys, I'm Alex Hudson.
And I'm Katie Claire Allen.
And this is the Show Choir Fine Arts Festival. The final event of the year, really. Tonight is a celebration of a great year in choir. Katie Claire, what's your favorite memory of Radica?
My favorite memory of Radica was honestly just the Monday night rehearsals and learning the dances with everyone. I know it was hard at times, but we got through it, and we got donuts sometimes, so it was fun.
We did get donuts. My favorite memory was sweeping Auburn back in February. That was a real treat. Well, remember Rubik's Cubes?
Hey, remember Miss Mixon's perm?
First up, we have our junior high choirs performing an 80s show with songs such as Take On Me.
Always Something There to Remind Me.
I Love Rock and Roll.
We Got the Beat.
True Colors with
soloist Rachel Vickery.
Carry a Liaison. Hooked on a Feeling with soloists Will Butler, Benjamin Grant, and Caleb Tucker.
Final Countdown.
And Footloose.
So
please.
Let's give it up for the Junior High Choir. Woo-hoo!
Talking away, Thank you. Give it up for the junior high! Well, good evening. How's everybody doing? So my name is Kasey Mixon, and I have the joy, period, exclamation point, giant font, joy of getting to direct all these kids in choir. And it is such a blast. The future of the Briarwood Christian School Choir family is bright. Am I right? They are so incredible. Yes. Yes. I want to give a couple of thanks. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Joe Randall. He's somewhere in the building who choreographed the junior high show. Let's give it up for Joe Randall. Also, an alumni of ours, Riley Atkinson, choreographed our opening number. So let's give it up for Riley. Also, did you notice the incredible set pieces, the Rubik's Cube and the Pac-Man and the cassette tape? One of our moms made that, so could we give it up for Miss Sarah Ivy? And I also want to thank the Fine Arts Department. We all support each other. We're all so grateful to see kids use their gifts in different ways, and tonight's really phenomenal for that reason. I'd like to now ask my first group of seniors to come out onto the stage. Guys, senior boys. So my seniors this year have been incredible leaders, and I took a few notes so I don't forget to say any of this. They've led with joy, they've led with humility, they've led with inclusion, and they've led by example. It has been a phenomenal year for our seniors, so I'm just going to take a few minutes to acknowledge each one of them. And I've chosen a song that reminds me of them. We're just going to listen to about 10 seconds of each song, and we're going to start with Mr. David Houston. This is the song that reminds me of you. Thank you. And the reason that makes me think of you is because you are elite in so many areas of your life. This is David's first year in choir as a senior. I'm so glad that he came, but he is elite academically. He is elite in the fine arts. Not only does he do choir, he's in the band. He writes original music and has won awards for that. He plays soccer. He runs cross country. There's nothing the boy does not do, and he does it all as a champion, hence the song. You're welcome. But here's the thing about David that's so incredible. David, you are the most unassuming person. You are so unassuming. You have all these incredible gifts, and you're humble, and you're unassuming, and you like to see other people succeed. And I'll tell you this right now. You're going to change the world, and I can't wait to see in which way. So that's David Houston. Next up is Mr. Garrett Harmon. And this is the song that I chose for you. The reason that I chose that song is because Garrett is a show-up kind of a guy. He has been in choir all the way through, starting at, I taught most of these kids choir in fifth and sixth grade, so I've known him a long time. He's been choir all the way through. He's been one of our dance captains this year, an incredibly hard worker. He goes the extra mile. This fall, when we were learning our show choir show, he was also one of the leads in the fall play, and he would often leave that rehearsal, come to our rehearsal, then go home and work with video to make sure he was ready to go. An incredibly hard worker. Also patiently helps others, shows up for the less fun things that don't get recognition. And that's what I want to focus on the most, because there are a lot of not fun things that happen in life, and you tend to show up for those just as much as you do the fun ones, and that's going to carry you so, so far. I'm very proud of you. Next up is Nate Baker, ladies and gentlemen, and this is the song.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no
Everyone sing along. Are you ready? Here we go.
It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem-free philosophy.
Tamatata.
So, Nate is a no worries kind of a guy. Nate is steady and level, but hysterical, one of the funniest people. Like, you have to listen closely or you'll miss it, but he is one of the funniest people I've ever met and a joy to be around. If ever you are nervous or uptight, it's hard to tell because you have this twinkle in your eye and the smile on your face. But here's what I'm going to say most about you, and I wrote it down. You have an ability to keep things in perspective, and you disarm other people around you. And so the fact that you can do that, it puts other people at ease, and you're a joy to be around for that reason. So I'm so proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Ahud is in the house. And this is the song I chose for you.
So here's to the memories. I'll forever keep them here with me. And I can't believe that it's over. So raise up your glass. Here's to brand new beginnings. And leave in the past all the things that are ending. Cause tomorrow will bring us a new morning sun.
Listen to this part.
My friends, I believe that the best is yet to come.
So I have had the privilege of also knowing Alex for a long time. He was in fifth and sixth grade choir. And I can say that I've seen you grow tremendously in every area, including, I wrote him down, you're an amazing friend, an incredible leader. You are the student section hype man. Like, you are the guy with his cowbell, with his wig, with whatever it takes. He is the man. Also, these last 3 years, you have stepped into your giftings in the fine arts in incredible ways. Your voice, your ability to act, your dancing. Hello, your dancing is amazing. Here's the thing that I wrote about Alex in a college letter. Alex changes the atmosphere of every room he enters in a positive way. He truly does. And here's what I want to say. I chose that song because it doesn't end here. The incredible development you have is just going to continue, and I truly believe that the best is yet to come. And at this time, we have the opportunity and the joy to watch our next show choir, which is Karis.
I'm trying really hard not to cry right now. Anyway. Next up, we have Karis. Choreography is by Taylor Meredith, Taylor Saladay, and student choreographer Lauren Edwards. The band is under the direction of Joel Mixon. Their series show, Inside Out, is based on the animated film, exploring each of the five emotions of joy, fear, disgust, sadness, and anger. In the end, we realize that each emotion is important and that balance of each of them is a gift. Please welcome Karis.
I knew that I would now.
so good, so good, I got you.
Thank you.
Baker, John Wayne. Showing up, shooting down everybody. You're classic in the wrong way. And we all know the end of the story. 'Cause everyone knows someone who kills the vibe every time they open up their mouth. Yeah, everyone knows someone who knows someone who thinks they're cooler than everybody else.
Don't sit up to hurt me no more.
before. Down every hallway's a slamming door. No way out, no one to come and save me. Wasting a life that the good Lord gave me. Then somebody said what I'm saying to you. Open my eyes and show me the truth. He said, just a little faith, it'll all get better. So I followed that preacher man down to the river. And now I'm changed. And now I'm stronger. There must have been something in the water. Oh, there must have been something in the water.
Okay, give it up for Karis. I know, incredible. A few more thanks before we move on. I would like to thank Taylor Meredith and Taylor Saladay. Neither one of them are here, but they choreographed that show and did an amazing job. I also want to thank Patrick, Alex, and Eli, who are the geniuses in the AV booth who make all this happen. Can we thank all them, please? I also want to thank Carrie Hand, who did the beautiful, she painted the pinwheel decorations behind the Karis. Give it up for Carrie. Also, somebody that we cannot do this without is Ms. Karen Milton. She does all of our costume alterations. She's incredible. Karen, thank you. And then I have a special shout out. If you were a universal chaperone, will you just stand up for a minute? Universal chaperones. Can we get the house lights for just a second? Okay. Everyone should clap wildly right now. Yes. Thank y'all so much. It was an incredible trip, but we had some challenges and we could not have done it without the team. Can I have my next group of senior ladies come out, please? Give it up for the seniors. Okay. Lily is up first. So Lily, this is the song I chose for you.
Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love.
So I chose this song for Lily because she is one of the worship leaders of Church of the Highlands, and this is one of their worship songs, and it's called Look to the Sun. And Lily has served as our chaplain this year, and I have to say her spiritual maturity is so far beyond her years. She does a devotion for us about once a week, and I usually leave being really, really challenged and blessed by what you have to share. And so I'm just so grateful for the way that you share your faith. Not only do you look to the Son, but you naturally point others to Him. And I cannot wait to hear about the way that you continue to do that in the next chapters of your life. There's a little happy for you. Next up is Miss Emma. Come on over, Emma, you're next. And this is the song I chose for you. Y'all, Emma has been through so many incredibly difficult challenges this year physically and with injuries, and not even just this year, over the past few years. But here's the thing, whether it's on the soccer field or in Radica or up here on the stage leading worship, you fight back. You don't step back, you fight back. And I see that fight in you that the Lord has given you for His purposes. But there's this thing with Emma that's really cool, because not only does she have that, she also has this ability to show up to do things that will get absolutely no recognition at all, and she doesn't want it. She's always there to pack the truck. She always shows up every single time, and she doesn't need recognition. So this incredible combination of, I wrote, tenacity and willingness is pretty special. So thank you for who you are and for being a part of our group. Next up is Rachel. And this is the song that I chose for you. So, this song is called Unstoppable, and I chose all of my Radica senior songs from Spotify. The difference in this song is that the artist who recorded that song, and it has, I checked today, almost 37,000 downloads, is Rachel. That's her. Mm-hmm. And the reason that I wanted to play that song specifically is because it shows your extreme level of talent. You're extremely gifted as a vocalist, as a songwriter, as a dancer, extreme level of talent. But to balance that, you have an extreme level of humility. And the Lord shines through your gifts because of your humility. And so Sanford has a good one coming their way. But not only at Sanford, in all the years to come, you are going to be, as your song says, unstoppable because of your humility and the way that you point other people to the Lord through your gifts. Next up is Miss Anna. Here we go.
Come, my little friends, as we all sing a happy little working song. Merry little voices, clear and strong. Come and
so there's no bigger Disney fan in the world than Anna. But there's also no other harder worker in the world than Anna. That is called a happy working song. And so I've also had Anna, like all these kids, since fifth grade, and you have always been mature beyond your years, far beyond your years. You also are so willing to help other people. Anna will make videos for people of choreography. She'll stay after school. Because here's the thing, you're a hard worker. But you don't have to necessarily work that hard. You're so gifted, but you want to, and you're diligent. But here's the thing, not only do you work hard and do well, you want to see others do well. And so it's not about you. It's about the group and other people doing well. And so that musical theater program at Sanford is going to love you, obviously, for your beautiful voice and your gifts, but for the way that you help other people succeed. And you want to see them be the best that they can. So thank you. Okay. It's about time for our Radica show, but before we do that, Ella Coons has put together a little 3-minute video with some pictures from the year, so enjoy.
Never call. Wednesday I'm here, I work my fingers to the bone. Thursday worries all around me. Friday I can barely breathe. I need a cure for the hurt that's ailing me. You feel no pain when your feet start moving. Just let loose and you feel alright. Just keep it going all night. Troubles, everybody's been alone. There's nobody here that could make it on their own. When your worries all around you got you bad and you can't sleep, listen, baby, and I'll tell you what you need. Can't feel no pain when your feet start moving. Just let loose and you feel alright.
Awesome. Okay, so we're going again. Okay, next up is Radica. Radica has had a very impressive season. They have swept at both Auburn and Opelika by winning best vocals, best overall effect, best choreography, and grand champion. Their show design and choreography is by Matthew Murphy and assisted by Taylor Saladay. The band is under the direction of Dr. Joel Mixon and assisted by Heather Gottlieb. This year's show, Seasons, is based on Ecclesiastes 3, which says, "For everything there is a season, and a time for everything under heaven. A time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, a time to dance." This show speaks not only to the seasons of the calendar year, but also the emotional and spiritual seasons of life. Now, for the last time, please enjoy Seasons.
I can feel you take a hold. I'm building a still to slow down the time.
Stop and remember me. the snow that floats from the sky. What is time? Is it the air we breathe? Or the wings that teach
all. turn. Never knew I had such a lesson to learn.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, give it up for Radica. All right, I've got one more group of people to thank and one more group of seniors. First of all, Matthew Murphy, where are you? Are you in the sound booth? Matthew is our choreographer, set designer, and designer of our Radica show. Give it up for Matthew Murphy. Incredible. Thank you so much. Guys, he is a gift to this school. He was in Mississippi in grad school last year, got married, and moved to Birmingham this year, and he is the other half of what I do. I'm so grateful for you, Matthew. Thank you so much. I also want to thank, where's Joey Coons? Joey Coons. Where are you, Joey? Stand up. Please. He's right there. He's waving. Along with Joey Coons, he represents all the parents that have helped this year for Karis and Radica, who've helped with set, costumes, truck loading and unloading, Mark Ray driving the truck a million different times, Julie Bean and others bringing snacks, anything and everything that we needed. It's a group effort. I cannot do it by myself, and I'm humbled and grateful for the constant support. So can all of my Radica and Karis parents just stand for a minute? Thank y'all so much. Radica and Karis parents. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Y'all are incredible. Thank you. We could not do what we do without your support throughout the year. I also want to thank Heather, Stephen, and Michael, who are three musicians that have traveled with us this year. They've been incredible. They've given of their time. And then if I could have Joel Mixon and his Acidar seniors come up for just a second. I want to thank Joel, guys. Joel, I'm going to go ahead and confess now, the only name that did not make it to the program for special thanks is yours. I'm so sorry. I literally proofread it 500 times. I don't know what happened. But y'all, this is my husband, Joel Mixon, who is a phenomenal musician. Phenomenal. And he gives of his time constantly, and I could not do what I do without him in every area of life. Particularly, we're talking about show choir world tonight. Not only is he an incredible musician, he drove the truck all the way to Orlando and back. So just for that, one more round of applause. Yes. Yes. He has three seniors, and he and Heather, his assistant director, have a few words to say about each of our Acidar, which, by the way, Radica spelled backwards is Acidar. So that's the name of, that's the name of our band, so.
Okay, great. Do we have their little, okay. So I just want to take this time to talk about three special guys that I have gotten to know over the last 3 years, and also Heather Gottlieb, who's a co-director of Acidar with me. She's an amazing musician, and she has been involved with these guys. She's got to know them the last 1 year, and she's brought a whole another level, our band to a whole other level. So I really want to talk about what we have. Heather and I put our thoughts together, and we thought about what we appreciate about you guys. Something that we see in you, what you've brought to our program, and maybe a charge for you going forward. So I'm gonna start with Noah first. So Noah is our drummer. Give it up for Noah Williams. So the first thing we thought about was cool as a cucumber, okay? He's a go with the flow, cool as a cucumber guy. But inside, he's an easygoing perfectionist, okay? So I'm going to say he's an easygoing perfectionist, meaning he wants to be right, and he wants what he does to be perfect, which is good and can be bad. But for the most part, it's really good. And this kid has grown as a musician over the last 3 years. He can now read music. He can read drum charts. Going forward, I don't know what God has for you, man, but you got to keep playing, you know? I mean, you're just a talent. I don't know if it's in church or in a band or what, but you got to keep playing. So Heather came up with this. I think it's right. Use your God-given abilities to continue to serve those around you through college and beyond. So, and I have a verse for you, 2 Samuel 22:31. We're a little more Christian-y than Kasey. She's doing songs, and we're doing actual verses. So anyway. 2 Samuel 22:31, this God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord proves true. He is a shield for all those who take refuge in him. And I know that you want to be right, and you want your music and whatever you're doing in life. I think that's how you are. But God's way is perfect, and perfect love casts out fear no matter what. So we are blessed to know you, man. Yes. It has been a joy, and I'm going to miss you big time. So. Okay, D. Lether is up. David Lether, how about it, buddy? Give it up for David Lether. So, and I don't know, just one aside, these kids, this is not a class period. This is a service hour thing that they do to help their fellow classmates, which is amazing. And they're doing this of their own time. They come at night. They rehearse with me. Mind you, we have a lot of fun, okay? But they are doing this out of their, you know, they get a shirt, okay? You know, so David is brilliant, for one, okay? And he basically has taught me physics of how saxophones work. So he's our tenor player, but he can probably play. He plays bassoon. He plays some other things, too. But he plays tenor in our band. David taught me about a high baffle and a low baffle mouthpiece. And so we learned all about that. And so our sound has gotten better because of him. David loves to teach. He's a teacher at heart. And I don't know if you know that. I don't know if his parents know that. But he can explain things well. And I think he likes to serve the kids around him. And I think you have leadership qualities, man, that are really, you're quiet, but you have these leadership qualities that we have gotten to know, Heather and I both. And Heather can jump in anytime. I'm not just bogarting the mic here. So I would say Heather's charge for you, and she kind of came up with the charges. Hers is continue to work heartily as to the Lord and not unto men, because that's what you've done. You've done it for your classmates. So a quick verse, Proverbs 2, to know wisdom and instruction, Proverbs 1, 2, and 3, to know wisdom and instruction, to understand words of insight, to receive instruction in wise dealing, in righteousness, justice, and equity. That's kind of what we thought of for you, man. So thank you, man, for all you've done for us. Big time. Appreciate you, buddy. Okay, give it up for Daniel Milton. The word that came to mind for me, and Heather had some words too, but the word that came to mind is preparation. And what I mean by that is Daniel is the most intentional kid that I've worked with in music. He is always ready. From day one in 10th grade when he started, he had a pencil. He was ready to take notes. If we had a change, he would say, Dr. Joel. He would not call me Joel, by the way. He'd say, Dr. Joel, every time. Because Heather and I are not employees, so we've told them to call us Joel and Heather, okay? This guy won't. Miss Heather and Dr. Joel. So he is so respectful. I don't know where his parents are, but it's amazing. So he's kind of the father of Asadar. He's an old soul. He's wise beyond his years. He leads by example. He is admired by everyone. You heard the applause he got. This kid just went through an appendectomy, okay? And he is here on stage like a week out of that. And you should see the response he got and the way that his friends rallied around him. And that is something, man, that you'll have forever. The way you touch people and the way you look into people's lives and see a situation, you're just so intentional. And I think, basically, Heather said, continue to seek wisdom from above. And I think that's the same thing. And the only verse that came to mind for me was 2 Timothy 2:15. And that's, do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly handling the word of truth. Because that's what you do. When you show up, you're ready to go. This guy's a professional, and he's made to be a band director, by the way. So I don't know if he's what he's going to do. I think he may be doing that. So anyway, Daniel Milton, thank you, buddy. Appreciate you, buddy.
Thanks. In general, can we have a round of applause for our band, Asadar? Last group. Here we go. I've got my last group of girls to celebrate, and we're going to start with McLean, and this is the song I chose for you.
You can count on me like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there, and I know when
so,
I need it, I can.
I got to work with McLean back in elementary school, and then she came to Radica this year as a senior. But since she was a young girl in 5th and 6th grade, I knew I could count on her. And I don't know if you remember this, but we went on a trip to Restoration Academy with performance choir in like 5th or 6th grade. And she was so responsible. I gave her my clipboard and said, can you please take roll for all these children as a 5th or 6th grader? She not only is incredibly responsible, She is one of the most truly joyful and enthusiastic people that I've ever known. And when she is in, girl is all in whatever it is that she does. Relationships, friendships. She's president of the SGA this year. She's led all over this campus, and she does it with joy and compassion and kindness. And that all-in person that you are is not only going to suit you well in college, but as a mom one day and as a wife one day, the way that you give all that you have to everything that you do is going to be amazing all the way down the road. So glad you came to be a part of choir this year. Next up is Miss Katie Clare, and this is the song I chose for you.
If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry.
So, you don't have to worry. Katie Clare, girl, you get it done, regardless. No mountain's going to stop it. No valley's going to stop it. You're going to get it done. This girl will dance with her hip out of socket because she will not quit. She will get it done. And I'm going to tell a story about you. You know I'm going to tell it. When Katie Clare, I have to. When Katie Clare was in fifth grade, the first thing they do when they come, or they came to me in elementary school choir, is I had to decide if they were a soprano or alto. So I brought them up to the piano in groups of like 10, and I would vocalize them, and decide if they're soprano or an alto. So at the end of this big sing-along moment, I announced to Katie Clare that she was an alto, and y'all, she burst into tears. She was devastated, and I was like, oh, kiddo, there are going to be harder things in life. I don't know what to tell you. I'm not sure what to say. But here's the thing about Katie Clare. Not only do you get it done, you care deeply. Your emotions are strong and real, and it's a beautiful part of who you are. You care for your friends deeply. You do the things that you do with all of who you've got, and nothing's going to stop you. Moving forward, Katie Clare is studying music education to hopefully get to do what I get to do one day, and you, my friend, will be phenomenal. Next up is Miss Lauren Edwards, who's already crying. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, this is what I chose for you. So, Lauren is somebody, and I've told you this before, who looks directly into people's souls. Directly into people's souls. You are selfless. You care for others beyond measure. You are giving. You are humble. Here's the thing also that I love about you. Not only do you notice when somebody's hurting, you do something about it. You sit and you talk with them. You do whatever that they need because you see their needs and it matters more to you than your own comfort. You also are, and I'm going to say this and I mean it, you're one of the only people I've ever known in my life, and I turned 49 last week. I've known a lot of people who is genuinely kind to the core. Don't ever lose that. Don't be tainted by this world because who you are is beautiful, and I see your true colors. Next up is Miss Ella Coons.
She's always buzzing just like neon, 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 neon.
So Ella is a big John Mayer fan. And so I went through his whole catalog to try to decide, and some of them are way too sad. But I chose Neon because Ella Coons is one of the most excited about life people and ready for the fun all the time. She is neon, okay? She is. She definitely is. But I told you this, like, she was our choir president this year. She's kind of like Alex in the whole school spirit thing. She is up in it with some school spirit. But the kind of leader that you are, whether it's having fun for school spirit or whether it's getting people focused in rehearsal, people can't help but get on board when you're leading. They can't help it. And the two words that come to me to mind about you the most, and I told you this recently, contagious intensity. And intensity can be considered a negative thing, but it's just not, because your intensity involves joy and an unwavering commitment to what you are doing. And other people are naturally going to follow that. The Lord's going to continue to open doors for you to lead in the next chapter in incredible ways because of the magnetic person that you are and the gifts that he's given you. And I can't wait to cheer from here in Birmingham. Now, all these kids in choir are my kids, but this one is actually my kid. This is Ashby Mixon, and this is the song that I chose for you.
You are real, and you are rare. I want to say I see you there. It's me.
When Ashby was like five, I'm not going to tell you her whole life story, don't worry. When she was like five, there's this whole thing that kindergarten kids do that they're like, they want to find out what their name means. And so people were finding out what their name means. So she came to me and she's like, hey, Mom, what does Ashby mean? And I said, well, it's Dad's middle name. And she said, right, but what does it mean? So in one of my finest parenting moments, I said, I don't know, I'm going to Google it. I didn't know what my kid's name meant. So she's sitting there like five-year-old Ashby on the edge of her seat waiting. And I Google meaning of the name Ashby, and it pops up, of the ash tree forest. And people have been finding out their name means like courageous and like called of the Lord, and she's of the ash tree forest. So you can imagine the womp womp moment that was. So I continued to Google, and what I learned about ash trees is that they have the strongest bark on the outside and the sweetest sap on the inside. And Ashby has really embodied both of those things in high school. She's not had one or two, but three total ACL tears, three surgeries, three rehabs, and she has come through that with such strength. And it has been truly admirable. Like, I have watched her in awe as she's come through that. But the song that I chose for you said, you are real. And the inside of who Ashby is one of the most authentic people, and I get to see up close and personal, the most authentic people that I've ever known. And the next part says, you are rare. What makes you rare and what I think your superpower is that you are not afraid to go deep relationally with people. You're not afraid of that. And the next part of your song says, I want you to know that I see you there, and you make people feel seen. When people are around you, they are seen, they are safe, and I, for one, have been a recipient of that. I have seen you give that to so many people, and that is what matters in life, loving people and letting them be seen, and the Lord shines through you in that way. I'm so proud of you. I've prayed for weeks that I would get through that. Whew, thank you, Lord. Thank you. At this time, Radica is going to present a very special song that we do every year called For Good from the musical Wicked. Our soloists tonight are going to be Lauren Edwards and Rachel Summers. And if there are any choir alumni in the house, if you would please come up and join us on the stage.
it's said, bad people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you.
Well, we've got one more song for you, and frankly, it's the most important thing we'll do all night. So, everybody be quiet on stage for me. I always like to end everything we do with a worship song. And the song that we chose this year is called Same God. And it calls to the God of David and of Moses and of Mary. It calls to the God who has been the same throughout time. And these seniors have had a real weird high school career. With this pandemic, so many weird things have happened. But this song reminds us that even in those difficult times, he's never changed and he never will. He's the same God. And the chorus says, my God, oh God, my God, I need you. And we've all had those times, and frankly, every day simply to get up and breathe, we need him. And this song points directly back to the fact that he never changes and that we need him. Okay.
You are the same God. told you before we began that tonight was going to be a special night. Was I wrong? you know, you saw a lot of neat things happen tonight. The abilities. I was winded watching them dance. And I turned to my wife and I said, how do they sing while they're dancing? Like, I'm super impressed. But more than the singing and the dancing, one of the things I do when I interview families is I tell them that I believe that Briarwood is going to be a place where your child will be known and where your child is going to be loved. And what Kasey Mixon did here today, talking about when you were in fifth grade, she knows these kids, has a song for them. Now her husband brought...
Okay.
They can sort that out at home. I'm going to be in trouble. She's going to tell him to cut off my mic. But that's why you send your kids to Briarwood. To be known, to be loved. And then what we just finished, I was walking in here right before this began, and a gentleman was telling me about, he's had a hard time with there's a situation with his family. And he said, man, something happened today. And like, what's going on, God? And I said, hey, just walk in here and let the kids minister to you. Just let the kids minister to you. Let the children come. I hope you were ministered today, particularly how we finished. And the second song always gets me because I'm just going to turn and say, I am better because I knew you. I love you guys. So whatever is happening in your day, the song you just heard, let it minister to you that God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and he loves you just like he did while you were yet a sinner. Christ died for us, and he loves us, and he loves us, and he loves us. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so bask in the beauty of God's love, the Father's love. Doesn't get any better than that. So thanks for ending this right. Thanks for loving the kids well. I think it'd be very appropriate that we show Mrs. Mixon our love and appreciation for her. Please stay standing. Let's close in prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And you are a generational God. You work in and through families. And we've seen many of our students that are up here are the sons and daughters of those who have graduated from Briarwood. And we thank you for generational faithfulness that because of Briarwood, because teachers said, I see you, I notice you, and I love you. And the only reason I can do that is because Christ has shown love into my heart. And as a result, I want to give away what Christ has done for me. And so we thank you that lives are changed at Briarwood. We thank you that because of you, we can sing, even though today may not be what we want it to be, but we know that you hold today and you hold tomorrow and you hold us in the palm of your hands. So, Father, I thank you for the Briarwood community. I thank you that you love us with an everlasting love, a love that will never end. And while we have done a lot of singing here today, it is nothing compared to what we will be doing around the throne room of heaven when we stand before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you. In your name we pray. Amen.